Hello, good morning students. Hope all of you are well. Today, for our computer, I am going to explain chapter number 5, that is Microsoft Excel. So, working on charts in MS Excel 2013. So, this is a very interesting chapter and very easy one. So, before I am going to start the portion, what we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss types of charts, elements of charts, inserting charts, editing charts. These things we'll explain. So, first we read something. Graphs and charts are very important tool in interpreting data. So, this particular picture you have seen, you are already familiar with the picture. Sometimes you have seen in the cricket match mostly. You have seen in the weather report, some share markets you have seen also. So these are the graph and chart, a very important tool in interpreting data. They are extensively used in business and education and have a wide variety of applications. In this chapter, we'll study about graphical representation. So this is a graphical representation of data. So, there are different types of charts we use for graphical representation of data. Now, I'll explain one by one the different types of charts. First, we have, what is chart? First, you need to know that a chart in MS Excel refers to data that is graphically represented. That is the most important, that is graphically represented. MS Excel has various types of charts with which are helpful in different circumstances, depending on the data at hand. So, it's a graphical representation. First, then among the charts, first it will come a column chart. And you see these two charts is given in our book, column chart and line chart. So, what is column chart? Column chart represent data by means of vertical bar. So, by means of vertical bar, it is representing. By means of vertical bar, it is representing. So, and this is the chart we are used most frequently. This chart we are using. So this is a graphical representation of data using a column chart. Same way, the representation is the different way we are representing. That is called line chart. Line chart represent data by means of continuous line that connect the data points. So this is a continuous line with a different color. It will explain the data like column chart. So here sedan, SUV, this different name of the cars is given. So they are representing that data through the line chart. So actually chart is a graphical representation of data, and here we are learning about column chart and line chart, and mostly we are using column chart. Column chart is a vertical bar representing, and line chart is a continuous lines that connect the data points. Next we have pie chart. Pie chart means a pie chart is a circular graphic representation of data which is divided into slices. So this particular chart is called pie chart. This type of chart you have already did in mathematics, in statistics. I think so. You have already did. You are familiar with the chart. In case of the numericals, populations type of numericals, you have already did. So this is very known to you. So what is it? It's called pie chart. Pie chart is a circular graphic representation of data which is divided into slices. In pie chart, the arc length of each slice is proportional to the magnitude of the quantity. So this is an arc, that is another arc, it represents the percentage of data. Okay, so pie chart are used to make comparison in proportion. So it makes a comparison. So these are 11%, it shows this part, and with a different color, of course, with a different color. And these are 37%, there's a 52%. And next we have bar chart. See, bar chart and column chart are near about same, but the difference is that it is in a vertical bar, and in case of, it's like bar chart is like a column chart, but in case of bar chart, it's a horizontal bar. It's a horizontal bar. But in case of column chart, it was vertical bar. That is the difference. And in case of bar chart, it can be used when category text is long and difficult to display in the column chart. So when the category text is very difficult to explain in case of column chart, so in that case you use bar chart. Next section we have area chart. Area chart are similar to and derived from the line chart. It's a similar and derived from the line chart. However, the area chart differ from line chart in the area under the lines are filled. So this particular picture shows a area chart. It's derived from the line chart. As you know, line chart. So this particular area chart is derived from the line chart. Okay. Next we have, what are the elements we have in our chart? So to read and understand graph, it is necessary to know the elements of the chart or graph. So this is a particular picture is given. So we need to know the elements. What are the elements? First is chart title. What is the chart title? So chart title, it is the heading of the chart that is described, that the chart is representing. So this is a chart title. So this particular chart made up of which topic it is written? Sales value, volume comparison for car segment. So this particular chart is made up of, based on that particular topic. What is the topic? Sales volume comparison for car segments. Okay. Next is vertical or y-axis. So what is y-axis? This one. Y-axis. So measures. So I am plotting something towards the y-axis. What I am plotting? That is the total sales. 0, 50,000, 1 lakh, like that. 1.5 lakh, 2 lakhs. This way I am plotting the total sales. So I am plotting the total sales according to y-axis. Then horizontal axis, that is called x-axis. So in the, according to x-axis, we are putting the years. So 2012, 13, 14. So in the respective years, what is the sales volume? So I am putting. So horizontal axis represent the independent values or categories in the above graph. Here is placed in the horizontal axis. Next is ligand. Ligand is the source, the data series and its color that is represented on the chart. That is called ligand. So this particular picture, this particular thing is identifying yellow for what, that is a blue for what, red for what. It is representing the all the things. Okay. So that's a called ligand. That's a very important section. Lastly, we have data series. The data series is a set of values in the worksheet that we want to plot in the form of chart. Each data series is given a unique color pattern in the chart that makes it easier to distinguish between them visually. Okay, so in that figure, data series of the charts are, what are the data series of in the charts? Data series of the charts are sedan, that is a that one, SUV, okay, then hatchback. So these are the data series. So this chart, before we are going to start the chapter, before you are going to know about chart, we should know the elements. Suppose this particular chart has drawn, so we need to know the elements. So first one is known as chart title. Second one is known as toward the y-axis. We are plotting the total sales. Now horizontal axis, that is the x-axis. We are plotting the years. Then ligands, very important, ligands. So the data series and the color represent on the chart. Data series and color represent on the chart. Next is data series. Data series is a set of values in the worksheet that we want to plot from the chart. That is one. So this is very important section, the elements of chart. It is very important to know. Okay, we are going to the next one now. Next we have how to insert chart. to insert chart, we need a table, particular table we need to insert a chart. Select the, first we have to need a table to create. After creating the table, we have to select the particular table. After selecting the particular table, we will go to insert tab. Where we will go? We will go to insert tab. Then in the insert tab, we will go to chart option. Here picture you can see. Insert tab in the chart option. Then they will get a list of charts. And we have to select which one you need, you will select. Here in this case, they are selecting the line chart. In line chart, there is also varieties, categories also. This particular things also you can select. After selecting that, everything has completed. You will can create this particular chart. So inserting the chart in the worksheet. Then you can create the particular chart in the existing worksheet or new worksheet. So the chart has created. So this is the x-axis, horizontal axis, y-axis, vertical axis. There's a heading, chart title you need to give, and that is the ligands. So these four elements we have already learned about the elements also given. So this is a representation of a chart. After creating a chart, we can edit details also. Sometimes if we need that, we can modify our chart, we can edit our details. Okay, so what is written? After inserting a chart, there are several things you may want to change about, want your data to be displayed. Suppose you want to change the value in the table, so chart will automatically update it. You want to change the chart title, you can change the chart title. You can change the color of the ligand, you can change also. So there are many things you can edit after creating the chart also. This particular feature is also available here. So add chart elements. So these are the chart elements you can add also here. There's a quick layout also given. So add chart elements. How you can add the chart elements? So here is the options are there. Chart elements you can add it. After this, shortcut button also there provided. You can add the chart elements. What is given? What is chart? Chart element is a component of a chart that add details to it. Chart element is a component to add chart details to it. So chart elements are, what are the things are there? Axis titles, chart area, and also guidelines. Chart elements are given. Okay, so this way you can add the chart elements also. Next we have chart styles. Chart style. So we can change the chart style in different format to modify the appearance of the chart. So to change the chart style, go to the chart style group. Here the picture is given, chart style group and design tab. Where you will get that one? In design tab. You will select the required one, which one you like. Then you will click on that. It will come in your screen. Changing chart type. So you can change the chart type also. So chart type also you can change. You go to design tab. Same way you have to go to design tab. So this particular thing, change chart type. Then change chart type dialog box will appear. Select the new chart type and layout. Click on OK. You will choose the column chart. Here in this case, you are selecting the column chart. I am showing you the picture. So previously you were having line chart. After that, there is a change in chart type option is there. You have selected the chart type that is called column chart type. After selecting that, you now the current chart type is column chart. So it will become this way. So this particular chapter is very interesting and very easiest one. So you can go through the chapter very well. If you have any doubt, any query, you can inform me. So please go through the chapter very well. This is a very interesting chapter. And I know this is a practical based chapter, but for the time being, you try to remember the theory part also. If possible, I'll show you the practical part. So students, I hope this particular small video will help you a lot to understand the chapter. Okay, thank you very much. Goodbye.